Hello, I am Dr. Shrinivas, consultant urologist working in Manipal Hospital, Whitefield, Bangalore. We treat urinary incontinence, which is accidental leakage of urine, in various ways. One is non-surgical treatment with some lifestyle modification, some behavioral therapy. Also, some amount of drugs that are used in very mild form of urinary incontinence. But the mainstay of urinary incontinence treatment is surgical treatment. Non-surgical method of urinary incontinence treatment, which is treatment of accidental leakage of urine, is done in the form of lifestyle modification, wherein we recommend the patient to lead a very active life, wherein, you know, we ask them to reduce the body weight, we ask them to cessation of smoke, that is stop smoking in case they are smokers. We also ask them to practice a technique called as urge inhibition technique, where whenever they feel like passing urine, we ask them to avoid that urge, divert the mind, sit for a few minutes, and then try use the washroom. So these are the ways that we prevent. And in addition, there is also a role of drugs in urinary leakage prevention, but these have a very limited role. They are only tried in mild form of urinary incontinence. Surgical treatment for urinary incontinence is recommended for all forms of urinary incontinence, especially the ones which are precipitated by stress in the form of coughing, sneezing, that leads to accidental leakage of urine. So there, you know, the mainstay of treatment is what is called as sling surgery. Earlier, we used to do what is called as a major surgery in the form of suspension of the around the urethra and around the vagina. The tissues are held up, they are pulled up, fixed to the bones at a higher level. That's how they used to be treated. Now we have a very beautiful surgery wherein we just use a synthetic tape or human tissue tape. We put it as a support under the urethra, which has a very faster recovery. Insertion of these synthetic tapes or tapes made out of the human body itself will act as a support. It's like a sling which supports the weak periurethral tissues, that is urethral tissues around the urinary passage. They're strengthened by addition of this tape. So whenever there is a rise in the intra-abdominal pressure during acts of coughing, sneezing, it is taken care by this extra support. The beauty of this surgery is, though it is a very minimally invasive, faster recovery, minimal hospital stay, the effects of the surgery remains lifelong. Most of the surgeries of this kind has a result of 80 to 90%, even up to the 10 years, 15 years after surgery, they have sustained result. There are minimal complications related to this urinary incontinence surgery. They are in the form of mild pain at the operated site, mild swelling, very minimal, you know, blood at the operated site. Very rarely there are complications in the form of infection or migration of this sling from the urinary passage area to the surrounding area like vagina or bladder, which are very rare. In such a case, it may involve no requirement of antibiotic therapies. In rare cases, it may involve removal of the sling. This surgery involves either a day care or one day in hospital stay in the hospital, and the surgery is of a duration of half an hour to 45 minutes with very minimal cuts around the genital area. During the hospital stay, the patient is inserted with a, you know, urinary catheter, which is removed on the next day of surgery, and the patient will immediately, within 24 hours to 48 hours, the patient will see that there is a sudden acceptance of control in the urinary passage. So she doesn't have any leakage within 24 to 48 hours after surgery. That is the beauty of the surgery. And the follow-up is very minimal. Within a week or two, the patient can come back and report about minimal, you know, side effects of the surgery. And then later, the patient doesn't require any long-term follow-up. When we say about colpo suspension, it is done for a condition where after the hysterectomy, after uterus removal in women, the vaginal tissues, they lose support and they sag down. So they require support for them to be lifted up. So we have a surgery called as colpo suspension where we lift them up and we fix it to the bones with the help of a few, you know, synthetic materials called as meshes. So in such a case, it is done in a very minimally invasive technique called as laparoscopic colpo suspension, with very faster recovery and very good long-term results. Very commonly, women do not attend to this problem, they do not seek medical help because of the problem, you know, they think it's a problem that they have to live with. So they do not know that there's a beautiful surgery which is a very simple, minimally invasive, with faster recovery, with almost no long-term problem at all. So urinary incontinence surgery is a surgery which many women may require. Only thing, there is no awareness of this problem.